right, so let's get to the brass section of the Synchronized Special Edition Volume 2, and we'll start with the Viennese horn and the staccatos. And of course, the beautiful legato that you have with all the instruments. I love it in the higher regions. And if you want longer notes than the one that we recorded, you can just switch to the legato sustain with the key switches up here and just switch to the legato sustains right after the transition. You get a sustained note. So you always get an option here. You have the sforzato. And of course, you get all the articulations you get in the plus version of the Synchronized Special Edition Volume 2. You get staccato, portato, legato repetitions. Let's just have a look what they sound like. The staccato. The same with the portato. You get the legato repetitions that are pretty cool. With natural note transitions, but also the staccato repetitions. The transitions are what makes these articulations special. You also get trills, half-tone trills, with a release sample on the last note when you leave the key. Whole tone trills. And of course, the fast repetitions that are pretty cool for stuff like this. You just get repetitions in 150, 170, and up to 190. Depending on how long you hold the keys, you get 1 to 9 repetitions. When you leave the key, you get the release sample. And of course, that also is true for the horn ensemble with 8 players. Now let's listen to what 8 players do in an orchestra setup. And of course, the legato is super impressive. And if you're like me, you will want to control the velocity. So you go to the perform page, switch on velocity crossfade, and then use CC2 to just really play with the dynamics of the instruments. So you can play around with these options here. With the legato, that's great. You have the half-tone trills and the whole-tone trills. Of course, also velocity crossfade is effective here. You can go to the whole-tone trills. You get automatically get a great response of these special articulations. You can also just improvise and just see what you come up with if you play the fast repetitions. So it's very inspiring articulations you have hidden here. And that's it for the horns that we recorded. Let's get to the trumpets. Starting with the piccolo trumpet, really small instrument, very high. Of course, the key switches are now in the left hand. Legato sounds like this. And it's nice to hear the valves work. Of course, the trumpets are not On the other side of the orchestra, the horns are here to the left and the trumpets are to the right in the back. So you always get some orientation. Don't forget that you can change the position or the distance to the player. So I'm switching to distant now. So you can always change that for every instrument and just decide how far away from the microphones you want to be. The same articulations in the plus collection. Let's go to the muted trumpet in C. In legato. So you have the trumpet in C with a very distinctive sound, the trumpet ensemble muted, also great sound. Legato. And the note transitions are what you're after in brass and woodwind instruments, just as in the strings. It's really the authenticity of the different transitions between notes. Tenor trombone muted. You can see there's quite a few muted instruments here in the volume 2. Tenor trombone sounds like this. Legato key switches up here again. Great sounds also hidden in the plus collection. Let's check out what the fast repetitions sound like here. So you get a great sound there. Let's get to the contrabass trombone while we're playing down here in the lower regions. That's some impressive stuff. If you're looking for low sounds, go for the contrabass trombone. Because we're at the short notes, let's just check out what the different staccato and portato options sound there. With the portato articulation. Legato sounds great, of course, as well. And the cool thing is that you also feel how the transitions for such a mighty instrument just take a little longer until the instrument is filled with air. So you have a kind of a natural latency that the instruments, actually every player has to fight with when they are playing these instruments as well. You have some long notes, you have some dynamics, sforzato. You have a forte piano here. So that's the contrabass trombone, and you have the trombone ensemble in a muted version, staccatos, legatos. Hear these nice transition sounds and of course the articulations that you find in the plus version of the trombones. Now let's get to the low brass with a contrabass tuba. So we're covering all the low brass with a contrabass trombone and the contrabass tuba. Totally different sound. And you can check out the contrabass tuba plus again with all those additional articulations. You also get trills there. I don't think those are easy to play, but they're easy to play with the synchron player. And you get the Wagner tuba, which is basically a trombone, as you know, also with a very specific sound. And a pretty impressive range there. Legato sounds like this for the Wagner tuba. And that's the brass section of our Synchronized Special Edition Volume 2. Horns, trumpets, trombones, and some pretty impressive low brass. And we'll get to the keyboards and percussion in the next video.